Hey guys, welcome to my video. Today I'm gonna teach you 13 tips and tricks that you should know about your iDevice, iPhone, iPad and iPod Touch. Please stay with me after the intro.
If you like to take a selfie with your iDevice, it's gonna be easier to do with the remote of the Apple headphones.
Therefore, connect the headphones to your iDevice and then launch the front camera. When you're ready to take a shot, click on the volume up button. I just took a selfie of this nice flower. On your iDevice keyboard, whenever you need to type in a password or a sentence that contains only one or two numbers, save time and don't switch between the alphabetic keyboard and the numeric keyboard. What you should do? While still on the alphabetic keyboard, tap and hold your finger on the 1-2-3 icon and then drag your finger to the necessary number. Again, tap and hold your finger on the 1-2-3 icon and drag your finger to the desired number. When you're ready, release your hold. On the calculator app, if you made any mistake, instead of clicking on the C button and erase the whole number, swipe your finger from left to the right on the number, and we're going to erase the first number on the right. On any app that you're using, instead of swiping your finger from top to bottom in order to go all the way to the top of the page, simply tap once on the top bar where the time presents and you will be direct to the top of the page. If you find your iDevice menus too bright for you on the nighttime, we can do it more low light friendly, something that will look like that one. In order to do that, go to Settings, here click General and then Accessibility. Now switch Invert Colors to On, and there you go. Not many people know, but you can actually set a timer for your music to stop playing in specific time. In order to do that, launch your clock app, now click on the timer on the right bottom side and then choose when timer ends. Scroll all the way down and click stop playing. Click set on the right top corner and now you can set the timer between 1 minute to 24 hours. As of example, I'm gonna choose 1 minute and I'm gonna click start. This feature is extremely useful if you like to fall asleep while listening to music or if you like to meditate. If you do like to meditate, make sure to check Vortex Success, which is the best meditation channel on YouTube. You have the link on the screen and also in the description down below. While typing on iPad, you may find it a little bit uncomfortable to type it in the regular way. Therefore, split the keyboard by dragging your finger away from each other from the center of the keyboard out and make it thumb mode. If you're using Google Maps as your Navigate app, you have the option to download and save section or portion of the map for offline use. This feature is extremely useful while traveling abroad or if you have Wi-Fi only iPad model. So zoom in to the section that you would like to save and when you're ready, click on the search bar. Now type in OK Maps. Click search. And then you will be asked if you would like to save the map. Click save on the bottom of the screen, name it and click save. You will see the download process on top of the screen. Now you will be able to access the map even while offline. While surfing your iDevice browser, save time and instead of type in .com or any other extension, tap and hold your finger on the dot icon and here you have popular extension to choose from. Swipe your finger left to right until you find the right extension. When you're ready, release your hold. When listening to music with your Apple headphones with the remote, tap once on the middle button in order to play or pause a song, double click in order to skip to the next song, or triple click in order to go back to the previous song. Even though that your iPad dock contains only 4 icons, you can actually put up to 6 icons on your dock. If you would like to put more icons on your dock, just simply tap and hold your finger on one of the icons and then drag it to your dock. The great thing about it that it's not only going to work with specific app, but also with folder. When you're satisfied, click on the home button. When typing a sentence on your iDevice keyboard, you may find it a long process to switch between the alphabetic keyboard to the numeric keyboard in order just to put a period and then switch to the alphabetic keyboard again. Skip this step by double clicking on the space bar. By doing so, you will add a full stop, a space, and capitalize the next letter.
If you would like to charge your device with a faster pace than usual, go to Setting and switch Airplane mode to On. That way, you will charge your iDevice twice as fast. As for example, we're going to compare between the right iPhone, which is on Airplane mode, to the left one, which is in regular mode. Both devices have 20% battery level. After 5 minutes, you can see that the Airplane mode iPhone reached 4% more than the other iPhone.
Alright guys, please like the video and share it with your friends. If you have any questions, please let me know by leaving a comment in the comment box down below. Please also make sure to hit on the subscribe button to the right in order to subscribe to my channel and stay tuned with my newest tutorials. I also want you to check my other tutorials over here down below and follow me on the social networks. I will see you all in my next video. Bye!